God damn, I need IPA.
This is Beering Ain't Easy, your podcast for beer humor, dad humor, and beer tastings from Texas and beyond. So crack one if you got one and turn it up.
All right, everyone, welcome to Beering Ain't Easy, episode 34 with Adam and Drew.
Welcome to June. This is officially hurricane season in the Houston area.
It is getting steamy outside.
It's basically the time of year where you go and you buy out all the fucking teepee and food that you can at Costco just so no one else can have it.
And you pray there's a hurricane and you sell it on the black market when that comes.
I feel like hurricane season is the only time where it's completely validated that I food hoard at Costco and then have beer fridges that are just chock full all the time. It's like completely validated during hurricane season. Have you been stuck in Houston during a hurricane?
So the only hurricane I've experienced in my whole life was Hurricane Harvey.
Okay.
But I work at a chemical plant, and so I was at the plant the whole time. And so I didn't really witness like the true hurricane experience.
I got to spend a few of those hurricane events. One of them was Rita, which is right. It came right after Katrina, and everyone in Houston thought we need to evacuate. So I was in the city of Houston, not at risk at all, but I jumped in my car and tried to evacuate. And 14 hours later, I made it to North Houston from Central Houston. Then just drank the rest of that time. I mean, that's what you do during hurricanes when you don't have responsibilities at work.
Okay, so like I have a logistic question.
Yeah.
So you're in your car 14 hours. You travel like 20 miles. Is everyone pissing on the side of the road?
You would think so. But some of us came prepared, like myself. And I had Gatorade bottles, which I drank as Gatorade and then refilled as another liquid. Was, in the car.
Was Meredith in the vehicle with you?
No, I actually was trying to go get to Meredith in College Station because she was still at school at the time during Rita, and I did not make it to College Station. I made it to North Houston.
That was the question going through my mind. It's like, how did Meredith handle this situation?
Yeah, was she like holding or no?
I'm like in like the toddler mindset. Yeah. So what's going through my mind is like, did she get a diaper going into it?
She got the Depends. That's awesome. Also, we were here during Hurricane Ike. And so hurricanes, when you don't have that work responsibility, it's like, okay, I'm off of work for a while. I've got a full alcohol cabinet. You meet your neighbors and you drink. It's a hurricane party. It's a real deal.
So like for us, like when Hurricane Harvey was coming, it was like our first real encounter with the hurricane. And like we just like started to like freak out. Like we don't know what the hell to do because we didn't grow up around them.
Yeah, tequila.
So like, do we need to board up our windows? Like yeah. Just have no idea what to do. And so then like this hurricane was brutal for me at work because I was there. I think you were there,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I was there.
I was there for like 5 days, like because I don't remember the exact time, but it was a long time. And that was
a lot of sleeping in the office.
A lot of sleeping in the office.
Yeah.
But I've never gotten paid so much. That was awesome. But I did feel like, so I was talking to my wife and there was a couple families staying there and a couple of family staying at our house who like had to evacuate their areas. And so like everyone's having a party at my house basically the whole time.
Yeah.
I'm like, damn it, I'm stuck at work and y'all are having a party.
You know, one of the topics of today that I really want to get into is a little bit about Father's Day. But before that, I think we need to get into this beer topic because I got an empty beer over here. So I think I'm going to crack what we got and we're going to talk about it.
All right, go for it. And let us know what we got today.
So we got a crowler. So this is like, oh, wow.
Blew it all over his face.
What could go wrong?
Wow, that beer looks so much different than what I was expecting.
Okay, so I'm going to introduce it now that this has been a little rough start. Yeah. So let me back up a second. So we are actually drinking a beer from Ingenious Brewing Company out of Humble, Texas. So I really haven't had a lot of Ingenious beers because I don't make it up to Northeast Houston all that often. But I was on a camping trip with my two daughters up to Lake Houston Wilderness Park. So we popped in and got some beer to go. Ingenious has always intrigued me, though, because they have like some of the best can art in the Houston area. So I'm excited, not just for the beer we're trying today, but some of the others I have back in the fridge. And so this one today is called Hempwing, coming in at 8.3% alcohol. It's an IPA. And so what's interesting about this IPA, and something that we've never done on this podcast, is it is infused with CBD oil. So this is I guess the closest thing that you can get in Texas to a weed beer.
So have you ever used CBD oil before?
No, I haven't. I see it like at the gas stations, at CBD clinics. It's like you can use it for your joints and shit. Like what is CBD? It's like the non-THC version. It's like extract.
Apparently. Like I don't really even know anything about it, but I have had. So I work at a chemical plant, as do you. And we have to do random drug tests in our line of work. And I don't know, maybe 2 years ago, someone was like, hey, if I use CBD oil, am I going to fail a drug test? And I'm like, I don't know. And so he called the nurse, the plant nurse, and asked her. I'm like, come on, man.
You know, both Adam and I like IPAs that have a little bit of that dankness. But this actually has the CBD in the IPA. And so when I look at the color on this thing, it's super dark. It's almost like a greenish brown murkiness to this beer.
Yeah. So it does not look like any beer that I've ever seen before.
Take a big whiff of that bad boy. I got a little ganja.
I don't know. Yeah, I got a little ganja. I got like no IPA smell, though. Yeah. Like no hoppy smell to it.
I don't either. So this is like a novelty thing. This weed beer, CBD, like I had to buy it because I didn't know what it was.
I haven't really heard of CBD oil beer at all.
So you heard about Sweetwater Brewing Company out of Atlanta, right? They were bought by a cannabis company, I think Afria. And so they've talked about making THC-infused beer so that you actually get weed in your beer.
Oh, really?
But I think what we're drinking is like the pot has not been legalized in my state, so we're going to get as close as we can to the real deal. And that's where they've infused it with CBD oil. So what's funny with this type of beer is that I texted my buddy in Denver, Colorado, where marijuana is legal. And I said, are CBD beers a big deal? And he's like, I think they ran their course in like a week.
For all the wannabe states, they're hitting the CBD oil beers. But for all the legalized states, they're like, fuck it, no one gives a shit.
They're just drinking an IPA with a blunt.
Yeah. Living the good life.
Wow. It does not taste like an IPA at all.
No. So this beer did not look, smell, or taste anything like I was expecting.
At this moment, we should research what the properties of CBD are. I've heard people put it on their joints and shit like that. I feel looser. I don't know if that's the booze or the, the CBD.
One of the two.
This almost just tastes like a thick, murky green. It's got a little bit of a green flavor, but it's like, not like dank.
I think it has like an herbal flavor to it.
It's almost like drinking tea and beer at the same time.
I wouldn't even describe it as dank. It's a green tea beer.
We're going to have to like stop, take some notes, and then come back and describe this beer.
I'm a little dumbfounded right now. All right, so while we drink these beers, should we talk about
Father's Day?
Let's take a moment to honor all the fathers out there.
It was a moment of silence while you drink.
I'm going to pour some out for the fathers out there.
I feel like Father's Day is that holiday that just gets completely steamrolled by everything. Like, is there a Father's Day that you remember that you're like, yeah, that was the greatest experience of my life?
So that's an interesting topic, because if I would bring Meredith in here, Do you think she would say there's a Mother's Day like that?
Probably not. Like, I think, yeah. I think as a parent, you just feel underappreciated all the time.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking, like, maybe, like, as husbands, we think we've accomplished more than we have, like, with our Mother's Day heroics.
Oh, right.
And so we're like, Father's Day, they don't do shit. But Mother's Day, it's like, we
moved the world. You got a point there, because I was just thinking during Mother's Day, like, the kids were at school and they were making these like really heartfelt crafts. And all I kept thinking was like, thank God that I did not have to help them make that craft and that the school did it for them, because fuck that.
So it's turned from a Father's Day to a asshole husband day.
Yeah, basically. It's like, why do you deserve a day? You're just a dick 24/7. Why don't you take the kids today?
Yeah. There is one activity that I do every Father's Day.
Okay.
And that is find a way to get myself to a brewery.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Have you been successful in that quest?
Well, like the last 3 years or so, since I've been committed to my new lifestyle.
Your best self?
Since I've been being my best self. But I feel like it's the perfect, I'm like, Joe, don't worry about it. You don't got to do anything. But sure as shit, we're going to whichever brewery I want.
And I don't know if it's me just like reflecting on the fact that I have three daughters and the only other males other than me in my house are my two cats. I feel like just getting out for like a guy's night out somewhere is like the best Father's Day gift. Cause it's just like, I love my kids and I want to spend time with them. But like,
But I don't.
I want to like just go to a brewery, go to a bar, just like.
So the guys, are we talking you and the two cats?
Yeah.
Or two human beings?
On leashes? Okay, like, this is a funny story. Like, have you ever seen somebody actually walking a cat on a leash? Because I went to a park, and I saw someone walking a cat on a leash, and it was the funniest fucking shit I've ever seen in my life. I was like, cats are not meant to be on a leash. They're not meant to be walked. It's like the most bizarre thing I've ever seen in my life.
So talking about Father's Day has made me think about a transition that occurs as you become a parent. It's the generational transition. And so like once you become a father, my priority of reaching out to my dad on Father's Day has just like drastically gone down. It's like... It is now my day.
Sorry, Dad, but you haven't had a kid in a while, so. Yeah.
Are you not the same?
I'll be honest, I'm pretty terrible, and I've been pretty terrible at getting birthdays, Father's Day, Mother's Day. I'm a terrible gift giver, so I don't know that anything has changed because I was terrible from the start. They'll be lucky if they get a card. Or on time or at all.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we were never spectacular at it beforehand. My older sister is like on top of it. Yeah. She's like the other day she texts me and she's like, it's mom and dad's anniversary. I'm like, how the fuck do you know that? I'm like, I barely know my anniversary.
Are they on Facebook?
Do you keep up with your parents' anniversary?
Of course I do. I mean, shut the fuck up. I know exactly the day I've got flowers delivered to their house.
Yeah.
Do you not?
The only way that I would ever send flowers there is like if I set it up one time and it was like a reoccurring payment, like with the same company, just auto delivered.
I feel like I have to do that now. I had to put like reminders in my phone for everybody's birthday and just I'll have a reminder for reminding me to fertilize the yard and then I'll have one to remind my brother.
Did you delete that? Because I was wondering when I walked over, I saw that lawn.
It's been recently fertilized.
Okay. So back to the generational transition. That's what I've done on my end, but I don't feel so bad about it because my parents have done the same thing with me. With my kids. So like they used to always like care about my birthday and like me in general, but pretty much, pretty much since I had kids is like all the focus shifted that direction. So now like Christmas and birthdays is all about them instead of me. And so out of spite, I've transitioned Father's Day to be about me and not my dad.
How's your counselor helped you out with these daddy issues?
It's been a long, hard roll. I hope he's listening now to show how effective he's been.
Adam is tearing up as we speak.
I feel like I'm talking to my counselor now.
So how does that make you feel? So I feel like with Mother's Day, I feel like there's always this pressure that I need to get something from the kids to my wife. And so this most recent Mother's Day, I took them to Target and it was like a clusterfuck because they were like trying to pick stuff that was like pink, sparkly, 12-year-old earrings. I'm like, no, mommy does not like that. Do you get that kind of shit for your Father's Day when you get like the kid picked out stuff?
No, I just don't get anything.
You don't get anything?
I wish I got shit like that, Drew.
Do you think the moms actually care that we helped our kids pick out dumb shit? All I want for Mother's Day is a bottle of wine and you to take my fucking kids so I don't have to deal with them. It's hard being a dad, though, man.
It is.
Dadding ain't easy. We get no respect. Actually, we've gotten this thing where we do gifts, especially Christmas. Because we want our kids to feel like they're giving us a gift. But at the same time, we don't want them to spend our money on shit. And so we let them go pick out the gift in the Target, $1 to $5 aisle.
Yeah.
Because they get to pick something that they feel so proud of.
Yeah.
I wish I had a picture, but I have, for Christmas, I got this little unicorn that has fake grass coming out of its ears. And I have that in my office because that was my gift for my youngest daughter. And she was so proud to give me that unicorn with the fake grass. And I was like, yes, this is exactly what I wanted. I still can't get over the color of this beer. It's kind of like what you expect the mystery machine and Scooby-Doo to come up on. They have a swamp and this is the water that the monster's living in.
It does look like swamp water
a little bit. Yeah, I was thinking swamp water is the best description I could have out of this beer.
Half swamp water, half IPA. This is what you get. The smell is just intriguing.
That's what I like about our podcast is we keep getting these random beers. It just keeps things interesting because if we were drinking the same hazy, that we wouldn't have a lot to talk about.
So if we actually try to describe this beer to our listeners, how would you describe it?
It's got the consistency of a thick, hazy IPA. It's a little bit floral and grassy. And it has almost that herbal tea flavor to it. It's bizarre. How would you describe it?
I get a slight blueberry aftertaste.
Whoa. That's very specific. I'm going to try to see if I can match
some of that blueberry yum yum. You have to put in a Luda blueberry yum yum mix into this.
Got that yum yum yum. Is that the song? No, that's Justin Bieber.
That better stay in the
clip. I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm going to put it
in. You don't know that song?
No.
Oh my God, are you serious?
No.
Luda told me it was okay.
Luda approved.
So we've talked a lot about CBD.
Yeah.
And you see states all over the place starting to legalize marijuana.
Mm-hmm.
What is your prediction when the state of Texas legalizes marijuana?
It's a great question.
Are we getting too political here?
We've done beer politics, so I think this is fair game.
Weed politics.
So there are a lot of libertarians in Texas who believe in individual rights. And so they will totally support legalization of marijuana because it's my individual right. I can smoke it or I don't have to smoke it. So I feel like because of that libertarianism in Texas, I feel like we're not that far away. I'm going to go ahead and make a bold prediction that by 2024, we will be legalized in Texas.
So this is a prediction coming from a state that recently denied changing the you can't buy beer before noon on Sunday. And so, yes, there are some libertarians.
Well, I think people would be okay with it if you legalize weed, but you just can't smoke it on Sunday mornings. Yes. Because God doesn't like you smoking weed on Sunday mornings. Apparently.
You say we're close, but then you say 3 years from now. I feel like that 3 years from now, I think it's really possible that it's legal nationwide.
Maybe. So I gotta tell a story. When I was living in California, this was my eye-opening phase because at the time it was not legal in California. Now it is legal. But at the time, my next door neighbor started growing it in his backyard. And so he started in those orange Home Depot buckets. He was growing weed, and like we were up in my daughter's room and we were looking down into their backyard and we're like, what is that growing in those buckets? And then it was weed, and we're like, oh, that's interesting. But then he started planting it in his backyard. And that, I did not know this, but those plants grow fucking tall. They grew above their fence line. And he went on, he perfected his farming in his backyard, and he went on to move to Washington and start farming for real.
Really?
Yeah. So I thought that was...
So did you know him?
Yeah. Like he came over. We invited him to our daughter's first birthday party. He was growing weed. And like the only thing that was funny is because it wasn't legal. Every time there was a helicopter that you would hear overhead, I swear to God, I'd see my neighbor over there like looking side to side like, oh, dude.
It's going down.
They're good. It's going down.
So that does take some balls though to grow weed in your backyard.
Above your neighbor's fence line.
Like when it's illegal. Like, I mean, there's a lot of people that could...
Oh, yeah, bust you.
Yeah.
My mom came from Arkansas, and she was up in my daughter's room where you could really have a clear shot at their backyard. And she was taking all these pictures and sending it to her friends. Like, my son's in California. Look at what they do in California. All right. So I think we need to get back to rating these beers, right? So in case you had forgotten, we're drinking the Hempwing IPA from Ingenious Brewing in Humble, Texas.
Drew, what is your rating?
I'm not a huge fan of this beer. It's interesting. It's not the IPA that I'm looking for. With this one, I'd probably go a 3.25.
Wow.
I'm just not feeling it. What about you?
So that's interesting because I really like it. It's uniqueness. Like I've never... had another beer that tastes like this. I haven't had another beer that tastes anywhere close to this.
I know we've already talked about descriptors, but I'm almost getting a Jolly Rancher aftertaste on it. That's a little a
blueberry.
It's the blueberry Jolly Rancher. It's a little sour at the end.
I'm going a 3.875.
Is that a rating that you're allowed to give on that?
I have upgraded. I'm like dead split.
Should have got off the pot.
I'm going a 4.0.
Do it.
It's the connection with blueberry yum yum is really is what it comes down to.
I think that's about a wrap for tonight. What do you think?
I think so. I think
we had a pretty good random discussion about all things weed and Father's Day and
they're pretty much hurricanes. They're pretty much hand in hand.
Yeah. So if you're in need for that blueberry yum yum, get you some CBD oil IPAs.
We out, bitches.
This has been a Beering Ain't Easy production in Houston, Texas. Follow us on Facebook or Instagram. And if you want to see what we're drinking, our untapped handles are Beering Ain't Easy Adam and Beering Ain't Easy Drew.